Anyway, we came back to London, or to England, and I did my stuff in with ATV, and The Limits of Love was published. And then I sort of thought that, I don't know, I didn't quite know what I was going to do, and I then wanted to go back to Spain. I think it was partly because of the friends we'd had there, partly because I'd sort of had enough of trying to be a writer in East Bergholt. East Bergholt, I remember very well, I met Paul Jennings on the train. Do you know who Paul Jennings was? I met Paul Jennings, who in those days had a column in the Observer, and he was a fairly bumptious little Catholic man. And I met him on the train, and I'd just bought the Penguin Pocket Dictionary. And the Penguin Pocket Dictionary, for some reason, had those catchwords at the top of each page, and the ones that they had were very comic, actually. I don't quite remember. And I remember pointing that out to Jennings, and he wrote a column using what I had pointed out to him. But although we lived in the same village, he never gave me a ring to thank me for telling him or drop me a note, and I thought, as we say in the business, fucker you. And I've thought that about quite a lot of people who don't have any manners. I'm quite keen on manners, partly because of my father, partly because of Winchester, to which I didn't go, and manners maketh man, but also because I suspect manners is a sort of wonderful device, English good manners, for showing respect to people you don't respect. And I've always been very good at that, really. So I'm very correct when roused, very. Also very grammatical. So we hung around England, and then Stella Richmond said, I said to Stella Richmond, I really want to go back to Spain. Do you think I could go on doing stuff? Oh, yes, you're fine. So I was able to go back to Spain with some ideas or some books I can't remember to do into television plays. And I went back, and then I wrote another novella while I was down there, which was called The Graduate Wife. In those days, it was quite a thing in the posh papers, the Observer and places. Catherine Whitehall used to write about the, you know, the problem of the graduate wife. I don't know what the bloody problem the graduate wife was. I mean, I had a graduate wife. She didn't seem to have a problem. But apparently, graduate wives were not being properly treated by graduate husbands or non-graduate husbands, and it all had to have something done about it. The English always think something can be done about absolutely everything, especially those things that nothing can be done about. So, The Graduate Wife is funny. And The Graduate Wife is based, actually, on a couple who had come to see us while we were in East Bergholt, in our little cottage. And the couple was composed of Jeremy Atkinson and Janet, the wife that he had married after she had solicited my advice back in Oxford in 1954. And they had a child or two. We're now talking about 1960. And they came and stayed with us because they were on a circuit. And I wasn't aware of the fact, and again, I say the English as if I wasn't part of them. Of course, I am part of them, because I don't want you to say I'm not. On the other hand, I observe them. They're very good at cadging.